Over 400 former employees of Karri 1975 Limited received today their long-awaited land leases. Some received two-acre-sized agricultural leases and others received residential leases. It's hoped that the two-acre plots would help rebuild the agricultural sector and once again make the sector flourish. But while the ex-Karri workers were elated to receive their leases, they say more needs to be done to make the lands accessible. Mahalia Joseph has more.
One by one, the 489 employees made their way to collect their leases, something many of them had been anticipating for years.
I'm happy. I'm relieved to get it after, you know, such a long time. I'm making plans to build. You know, I'm excited about that. And my plans are coming through well. So I'm looking forward to finally having my house and moving in eventually.
After a long wait, I feel good.
Many who received leases said they don't know where their agricultural plots are located and noted that there are infrastructural works that need to be done.
Number one, they don't have proper roads. Number two, no access. If they give us land to plant, how we have to produce or to prepare the land is a lot of money. Even subsidies, we don't get subsidies and things. So again, but as farmers, it's very expensive to plant agricultural land.
At the distribution ceremony, it was announced that the lands will be taken away if they are not utilized for agriculture, but Mr. Tilak Singh disagrees.
He cannot say that. He has no right to say that. And somebody thinks he said is 14 years suffering. Imagine someone get it yet. Up to now, I do not know where my land is, where my 2 acres is, where it is situated. I have went to BC and I went to El Seguro. Not a clue.
Minister of Agriculture Clarence Rambarat, responding to their concerns, said the leases are being given out for agricultural purposes, so it is expected to be used as such.
Across the country, we have farmers who suffer with infrastructure issues. It's very difficult to maintain and manage, you know, over 900 kilometers of access roads, especially given the financial conditions. So I would not accept that as a reason. Of course, it's not my decision. It's a decision of the Commissioner of State Lands. But my position is that the government will put in place the appropriate policy requirements, and we'd also support the enforcement mechanism in the Commission of State Lands.
As for the infrastructural issues, the minister said that will take some time to be addressed.
So I think people expect paved roadways and highways and lights and water and telephone and cable and everything on agricultural land. I think we have to be realistic, and it is our intention to act in accordance with the provisions of those leases.
The ministry said more leases are to be given out soon. Mahalia Joseph, C News.